Well, first of all, I'm here to speak on behalf of the most oppressed, most abused, most murdered group of beings that has ever existed.
I mean, when was the last time a chicken or a cow attacked a human being? How about never? A pig, turkey, never. We're the ones that attack them.
Cows have harmed nobody. Chickens have harmed nobody. We are murdering innocent beings.
We send them to slaughterhouses. They know what's going on. They're aware. They're conscious. They smell death and fear and blood in the air. We cut them up into pieces.
The animals are not willing participants.
We're teaching them that it's okay to disregard animal life, that human life is more sacred than animals, when every creature on this planet values their life just like humans value their life.
We all suffer in the same way. We all feel pain in the same way. A knife in my throat is just as painful and harmful as a knife in a cow's throat, in a chicken's throat.
Because people don't realize how much they're harming animals in their daily lives.
Most people I know aren't evil people, but most people don't realize their daily choices support evil.
So if you put a knife in my hand when I was growing up, even though I ate meat, said, "Hey, Gary, go kill that cow," Millie, you must be crazy. I'm sticking that knife in somebody else's throat. So we pay other people to do it. So I want to reach those people that are passively evil, that passively take part in this, and that's the masses.
So I'm just pointing this out to everybody, because people don't realize how much they're harming animals in their daily lives. So as I point out, the steak, the hamburger, the chicken sandwich that you're eating, the schnitzel, okay, these pieces of meat came off the bodies of living animals who didn't want to be murdered, who didn't want to suffer and die, who didn't want to be tormented.
It is the most profitable business on this planet since the beginning of time, animal slavery. Nothing comes close. Not cars, not gasoline, not oil, not computers. Nothing compares to the amount of money being made off the backs of animals, literally.
I want to show people what's going on, because if you watch the news, if you watch TV, the advertisements are happy cows. So I went to a slaughterhouse on my own to see what was going on.
I heard their screams. I smelled death in the air. One of the most disgusting things, to smell fear and death.
Why don't they show you slaughterhouses and say, "Hey, this is where your hamburger comes from. This is where your chicken nuggets come from." They intentionally lie to you. I don't lie. I intentionally tell you the truth, because I think if you saw what was going on in the slaughterhouse, no logical person could choose to continue to eat animal flesh.
It is sad that we can't talk to kids about the truth, about what's going on in the world.
Every second, just so you know, of every minute, of every hour, of every day, female animals are raped to impregnate them. Every second, animals are being killed.
In America today, 30 million innocent beings will be murdered for a sandwich.
Well, we're talking 12 million people were killed by the Nazis. In 1 year alone on this planet, 60 billion land animals, 90 billion marine animals are tortured, tormented, and killed in the world's most massive Holocaust. That's just in 1 year alone.
And when we teach children that the Jewish Holocaust was evil, but then we send animals to their death, to the slaughterhouses in the same extermination trucks that sent Jews to their death, we're committing a gross error.
Remember, I don't do things to be a politician. I don't say things that people want me to say. I speak the truth, and the truth is harsh. I know people don't want to hear that there's a Holocaust taking place that they're taking part in, but that's a fact.
I call human beings murderers of animals. That's what we do. That's the truth. The truth is harsh.
They must look at us like we are devils. We cut things off their bodies, their horns while they're fully conscious, off the cows. We cut the beaks off of hens. We rip the testicles out of baby pigs when they're born. We have treated our cousins in fur and feathers so horribly that beyond a doubt, if they ever formed an organized religion, the devil would be depicted in human form.
Put yourself in the animal's position. Imagine somebody raped you to impregnate you. You gave birth to this baby. This baby was stolen from you at birth. That baby was fattened up with corn and soy and wheat and oats. That baby was put on a concentration camp truck, sent to a slaughterhouse, hung upside down, fully conscious, in front of all of her own species, screaming, terrified, in fear, knife shoved into, you know, her throat, cut up into pieces. Where's the justification for this?
This is why vegans get so militant, because I don't want to be a two-legged devil. to the animals or to anybody.
No injustice can live forever. Sadly, injustice can live for hundreds or even thousands of years, but no lie can last forever, and people are becoming aware.
Change is slow. It took 400 years to convince white people in America not to own blacks. You can see why this is taking so long.
I speak against speciesism in the same way Nelson Mandela spoke against racism.
We live on a planet that murders animals, a speciesistic planet. Understand, like a racist who thinks that their race is better than another race. Speciesists think that the human species is superior to animals, and we have the right to harm and kill any species we choose.
Where do humans get off owning and controlling living beings?
Do you know that if you took humans off this planet, the extinction of humans would benefit everything that exists? The animals, the forest, the air, the water, the mountains. If the bees disappear, everything falls apart. This is how special and valuable bees are to the world.
The issue is we just need to change the way we view animals. We have to realize humans aren't the only beings on this planet, and we're not more important than animals.
I'll show you hospitals full of people with heart disease, cancers, diabetes, osteoporosis, kidney problems, etc., all stemming from animal protein, the main cause of every major disease on this planet.
Now, here's what I love about the health benefits of veganism. When you're being altruistic, you should never expect anything in return.
Right.
When you're vegan, you get a lot of great things in return. Your health, you're good to the earth. Because let's face it, the worst form of environmental destruction is animal agriculture.
That's right.
So there are some great benefits and kickbacks, but without a clear conscience, without mental health, we can't have physical health. So if you're going to focus on the physical health aspects and miss this aspect, you're still not right.
I think when you put violence in, you get violence out. You consume discrimination and death, you're going to, you know, exude the
because
same
some
horrible
people may
things.
Say-
What's wrong with somebody choosing to be compassionate, choosing to be good to the environment, so children don't have to starve to death around the world while we're feeding 50% of the world's crops to 60 billion land animals in the meat, dairy, and egg industries? And find peace on this planet by eradicating speciesism.
You can start, you know, giving compassion to the animal kingdom, to the insect kingdom. Then you start living peacefully with the planet and with each other. And peace begins at the dinner table.
Because we claim to be moral beings. We claim to know right from wrong. We claim to be compassionate. And as long as humans make these claims, I'm going to be in everyone's face and say, you can't do it halfway. The path to peace is through veganism.
So it's logical to want to be vegan, to want to reduce and eliminate pain and suffering.
Once I point it out to people, most people, sane people, logical people, make that next step.
It's thrilling to know that people are paying attention and making massive change.
And as we go back in time and look at all the other people that we adore now, collectively, we all agree, Gandhi and Dr. Martin Luther King and all these people, Rosa Parks and Cesar Chavez, do you know, they were not loved during their time. They were despised. They wanted to make change, massive change. It's only later on that a society looks back at revolutionary activists and says, oh, man, he was great. He was just trying to bring peace and justice.
This stuff has to stop.